Yo, and welcome to the Ambition Hour podcast. I'm your girl, AuDii 3000, and this is episode 32! I am so excited because after such a long time of doing episodes and having our boy C.A.B out in Virginia, we have him here on the Ambition Hour podcast. I just want to give a warm dub-t-dub fam welcome to C.A.B. He's my other little big brother. Say what's up to everybody, Carlos.
It's an honor.
I'm really excited to have him here, guys. This is like my other little big... This is my other little big brother. And he is also an artist on the dub-t-dub fam. He has one of the sickest voices. I'm sorry, Javier. Love you. But he has one of the sickest voices, the sickest flows. I've literally seen him grow up as a rapper. And I'm just so proud of him, and I'm very happy to have him on the show. Like each and every single Ambition Hour podcast, I love to spread gratitude out to everybody who watched last week's episode, which is the episode with Trees. Thank you so much for tuning in. That episode was lit. If you have gotten a chance to see it, thank you. If you have liked or if you have subscribed since then, thank you. And if you are new to the WTWTV channel or the WTW fam, I want you to go ahead and subscribe. All I gotta do is just go hit that subscribe button and then hit the little bell. That way you get a little notification every single time we post something. As you all already know, each and every single Saturday we post a brand new video, a brand new song, and a brand new podcast. Speaking of brand new, Carlos, you and Laidback Sosa dropped in a project this past week, Cabana Boys.
Cabana Boys is a song on it, but it's called Cabana Classics.
That's the name of the album, Cabana Classics. Yeah. Oh, okay, and it's a mixtape.
Yeah, but Cabana Boys would have been hard too. But
oh, okay. See, that's I guess probably because like I see the cover of it, and then I guess the song. Even though you guys have that Dulce Piña Colada, have you ever had that?
Yeah.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's really good. You just need a splash.
You just need a splash of it. Yeah. I know you rap Spanish in the mixtape. What inspired you to do that?
I'm gonna say it. It was J.R. Ryder. Shout out to J.R. Ryder.
Who was J.R. Ryder?
J.R. Ryder, he's a rapper on Dipset. Well, it was. I don't know if they're still rapping together, but yeah, it was him, Cameron, Joel Santana. And he would do that shit all the time. He's Dominican, so.
Oh, so he would, like, kind of flip it?
Yeah.
I like that. I like that you did that because I almost have never heard you talk Spanish.
I'm going to say it, Claudia. I've always said I speak Spanish better than me?
Better than you. We'll have to see about that because your girl's Spanish has gotten
a little bit. No, your shit is fluent. I think I'm on the same level.
We're on the same level.
I speak Spanish all the time. My mom, my dad.
So oh, true, true. You do. And tell me about the other tracks that you guys have on the project.
Well, it's 11 tracks. And then it's, like you said, Dulce Piña Coladas. We try to keep it like beach vibe for the summer. But this shit like Payback too.
Payback is like a good one.
Hard.
Hav says that it reminds him of Hov.
Because it has some drug dealing references. So I guess that's where you got it from. But yeah, it's just, you know, for the street. Like just to...
And so explain to me the process of like the recording. Because you guys weren't recording this in the same studio together, right?
No, we're both in Virginia. But I haven't seen that guy in like, I haven't seen him in years. I don't remember last time I saw him.
Damn, that's crazy. So
I literally don't remember last time I saw him. Shout out to Laidback.
It must have been a long time ago. And so what you guys would like, you would get on the track and then you would send it back to him?
Send it to him and then we'd talk on the phone about it, send it back. And then it was just like that, a process.
And you guys have been making music for a very long time, so it was probably easy for you guys to do this project?
Yeah, we're always on the same page. Like, once I hear him say it.
Yeah, I feel like you two are very in sync lyrically. It's crazy. Yeah. But I also feel that you and Hav have that too.
Yeah.
And then Hav and Laidback. And then like...
we've been making music together.
For such a long time.
Since forever. So.
Do you remember Bump to Our Tunes? Mm-hmm.
I remember it, but I haven't heard it in a long
time. I haven't heard it either, but I remember that weekend. Remember that, how crazy that weekend was? It was one of the weekends. Guys, this is my little brother. So this was the weekend that, like, my parents were, like, out of town or something, and then the boys would just stay over. And so he would stay over. And then I remember that morning, like, they just all wake up, and then they record that song. That was pretty dope, right? Yeah, like, having cool. a studio.
Yeah, we just hang out and then record. It was pretty much what life's supposed to be.
What's one of your favorite memories in that, like, in that studio that we would have?
Just like hearing the product, and then just all going crazy, and then riding in the car to it, and then it just felt good.
It felt good. I know. I would love to see it, because there would be, like, a couch there. And I remember we used to, like, go on our little adventures during the day, and then you guys would record at night. Yeah. That was fun. Those were the days, man. Those were when, like, and it's crazy because that's something that we were doing back in the day and that we're doing now again. You know what I mean? Right, and it's right. like music always brings us together. Because I know that's kind of like how you and Hav met, right?
Yeah, we met talking about music, yeah.
Who were you guys talking about?
If I remember correctly, it was about, well, it was, he told me a story about, he was like stealing CDs from Target.
You're incriminating my brother.
I don't remember that part.
And I'm like, damn, bro, you going hard for some CDs, bro. And I was like, and then he told me he wanted to get the Shine CD. The Godfather.
Damn, that album was dope though. Shine was dope.
And then I told him, yo, my brother bought that shit. Like, he has, I can give it to you, you can burn it or whatever. And then
it just was from there.
That's how we started talking to each other and hanging out, talking more.
I'm pretty excited about that, because I know your guys' story. I've seen you guys grow up together. I remember the first time meeting you. I remember the first time meeting your brother. And, like, just having, like, such a big part of my life. And then to have you here. And then to even just, I remember the first time that I heard you, your song, like, your first song that you had made in, like, probably in, I don't know how long, right? The one that you sent that one time to Javier. What's the name of it?
Amistad.
Oh, yes, that one. I love that song. I remember we, like, played it, like, two or three times. How did you feel when you wrote that song?
It was just good. I was inspired by Sosa again. He had just dropped that Purple Waves. Mm-hmm. And I was like, man, this guy, he killed it. And
I was like, he's so sick with it.
Yeah, I'm like, what? I should be on the same shit. I should be recording my shit. Fuck a studio. And then that was just the first thing I did.
And then, is that the one that you mentioned, like, your brother in it or something like that?
I mention him. I don't rap about him, but...
You don't rap about him that much, right?
I because it's a Dipset beat, and then he loved Dipset.
Aw.
So he was like, yeah. The beat reminded me, it felt like those times when, you know, playing in the background, us hanging out in New Jersey, that's what it felt like.
Do you feel like a lot of the times when you pick certain things or when you come up with things, like, he's there? Kind of like...
All the time, yeah.
Yeah.
All the time.
Aw. R.I.P.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about that.
Oh, no, it's cool. We don't have to. What I did want to talk about on a lighter note, you guys, it is Beyonce's birthday. I'm so happy. I'm so upset because you didn't get to go to the concert. You were here for that, right? But you didn't get to go either.
On the run? No, I didn't go.
I wanted to go. I'm so mad at myself because even though today is her birthday, like, it's Beyonce's birthday, I'm, like, happy, but then at the same time, I'm upset because I didn't go to the concert, so that's what I've been thinking about. So every time that I hear,
why didn't you go?
I thought about it too much. I was just, like, I had the money, and then I just thought about it too much. I was just like, no, I can't just spend that money right now. I probably spend it on food anyway, so, like, yeah. It'd be like that nowadays, no?
I'm not really a concert goer. I don't know if you guys know, but...
You've been to a couple, though, because you've been to Rock the Bells.
Rock the Bells, but that was chill.
That was chill.
That was chill.
I remember around that time, you were, like, a Hello Wale fan.
Yeah.
Like, you're the one who, yeah, you're the one who hella put us on Wale, though.
Yeah,
and
Wale's,
I thank you for that.
That was before I even knew I'd end up in fucking D.C. and shit. I don't know. It just all full circle.
Yeah, that's something that, because you were basically the reason why I knew about Wale. Like, that was pretty cool, because you were the one who basically introduced us to Wale, and then I remember you wanted to go to Rock the Bells to kind of like see him perform or whatnot. And so I always
know anybody else. It was just Wale and Nas. Everybody else, like the Far Side and stuff. I knew about him, but I don't really listen.
Redman and Method Man were there too. Mos Def was there. That was kind of boring though. Yeah. did you get to see Nas that night?
Yeah.
You did, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, okay. But you stayed the whole time. And then A Tribe Called Quest performed, too.
Yeah, yeah.
Bro, that concert was bomb.
Yeah, it was really bomb. It was my first ever concert.
Yeah, no, I love that concert.
Do they still do Rock the Bells? Yeah.
I don't think they do it here. I think it's turned into, like, Rolling Loud.
Yeah.
Rolling Loud is really, really big.
Yeah.
Like, they did it at the stadium. That's where the Dolphins play. That's pretty crazy. So that was just something that I couldn't stop thinking about. But happy birthday to Beyonce. I love you, girl. Y'all know that on the Ambition Hour podcast, I love talking about Beyonce whenever we get a chance.
Shout out to Beyonce.
She's out here slaying her entire like tour. And I'm just so happy for her. That album is dope. I downloaded the title just so I could hear like some of the tracks. So, yeah. I got Tidal. I also got Spotify.
Thank God it got put on Apple Music, because if not, I wouldn't have heard the Carter album.
The Everything Is Love?
Is it Everything? Is that what it's called?
That's what it's called, yeah. Oh, okay. Everything Is Love. And then it's the Carters. But yeah, they have it on Apple, but they also... Tidal, I got the... Because the Chopped and Screwed one is only available on Tidal. I wanted to hear that Chopped and Screwed, because I wanted to see what they did, especially because she's from Houston. So I really wanted to see kind of like that dynamic of what they came up with. But shout out to Beyonce. We love you, girl. So Colin Kaepernick, has been signed to Nike this whole time? Is that what's been going on? Because that's what I keep seeing.
I'm not sure, but I think they gave him a bag.
Like, yeah, no, for sure. He's like the cover of the 30th anniversary of the company or something like that. And so a lot of people are mad. Some people are like even like throwing away their Nike stuff.
I saw a guy burn his Nikes right on his feet.
Right on his feet?
They were still on his feet.
And
he burned his feet.
people out here burning their Nikes and their feet. Like, it is not that serious.
That's really not.
That's, it's, I find the whole thing on... I always found what Colin Kaepernick was doing very commendable, because he's standing up for something that he believes in. Nice. You know what I mean? And that's just, you know, equality. And that's something that we don't really talk about politics and stuff like that on the Ambition Hour podcast. You guys know that, especially if you watch all the time. That's not something that we talk about. But if you really think about like what Colin Kaepernick is doing and what he's standing for and the money that he's raising, and then his goal that he has, and even the role that he plays in hip hop, because a lot of artists and rappers are talking about him, they're supporting him, they're backing up what it is that he's doing, you know, and like the even like just always including him in their lyrics is crazy. So it's kind of hard to not talk about him on a hip hop podcast, you know what I mean? As much as we don't want to talk about like really politics, but I mean, he is a part of the culture. So, you know, it's okay, but he's basically signed to Nike. As you heard him, a lot of people are like, they're burning the stuff, they're cutting it up. People are like, boycotting Nike. And it's just been all over the internet. Like, it's been crazy. It's been insane. It's been pretty crazy on how the internet has been taking it. And it's funny because you don't even got to watch the news anymore, because it's all on social media. I don't watch the news, but I know what's going on. So I know one of your favorite albums, well, maybe Kanye albums, is Graduation.
Graduation, for sure. Yeah.
What's your favorite track on Graduation?
If not Homecoming, it'd probably be I Wonder.
Ooh.
But I always play Homecoming when I come back here.
When you come back
here. I feel like I'm in slow motion and shit. It's just one of those type of vibes.
Yeah, I love that. One of my favorite songs is Flashing Lights.
Flashing Lights.
From that album.
Number nine.
Yup. Didn't you go to Glow in the Dark?
No, I didn't go.
Oh no, you did. Your brother did.
My brother did.
Your brother did. Yeah. I remember like knowing that somebody else like that was close to us going.
Uh-huh.
But what other songs do you like? So you like I Wonder, Homecoming. You were like in what, a high school? Still in high school when that album came out, right?
Yeah, it came out like during my graduation and stuff, and it was that's why it was. This is it.
This is for me. yeah, no, and then he had that whole like 50 battle type of thing.
Right, yeah.
Is that your favorite Kanye album? Like top?
I like My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy too. Mm. And I like Heartbreak.
You like 808? Javier loves that album.
Yeah, I've seen Javier perform that live. The whole thing straight through.
You seen him perform? Can you please explain that? Like, what happened?
We went to it was like a family parties of your families, and they were playing Rock Band. and he just played it on the loudspeaker, and instead of using the mic for the game, he was just throwing a concert. That was my first ever time I saw Javier perform. Just random.
Bro, the thing is that he's been doing that his entire life. Like, that is so fucking funny. Like, because he's been doing that his entire life. He's been performing his entire life. So, like, now when I see him, it's like, it's not too shocking for me because it's just like, bro, you've been doing this forever. Like, it's just funny. You've never performed, right?
Never, never.
Do you ever think about, like, how when you would perform, how you would be?
It probably goes bad. It probably goes really bad, but who cares?
You know what's funny? I saw this movie on Netflix. Shout out to C.A.B. He's always the one who gives me, like, really cool shit to watch on Netflix. Always. Nice. But it was this movie called After Party. Mm-hmm. And it's, like, I guess it's, like, executive produced by World Star or something like that. And it's basically...
Well, it's new. It just came
out.
Right?
It just came out. It's funny because it's about...
That's your boy Kyle.
Right.
Oh, that's him.
Kyle, yeah.
Okay, cool.
I saw him
perform
at Coachella. He's really good.
Really? I knew he was an artist, but I just didn't know who he was.
No, he makes super dope music.
Yeah, and he was a pretty cool, he's good basically actor. The lead, yeah, and he was the actor. And it was funny because it's like this dude's performance, and it's his first time he smoked with Wiz Khalifa before the performance. So then what ends up happening is that he gets a little sick, and mid-performance, he like, fucks up, and he, like, starts throwing up on everybody. It's pretty crazy, but it was a really good movie.
Yeah.
And so, like, I always think of that. Like, I remember one of the times that I went on stage. I'm not a performer. You guys know I'm not a performer.
What
have
you done on stage?
Well, because they were performing a song that I like. Okay. Hav and Spitz were performing a song that I like. I mean, I've gotten on the mic before, like, next to the DJ. But I quickly found out that probably wasn't the best idea. But this time it was like my favorite song. And then I told Space, I was just like, yo, I'm gonna get on stage. And you know, bro, when I tell you that before I got on that stage, my stomach felt some type of way. I was just like, a bitch is gonna pass out. Oh shit, something's weeping over there. Okay, so we already talked about, what are your favorite concerts that you've been to? You've only been to a couple, but...
I don't know what the Lil Wayne one was called.
You seen Wayne in concert?
Yeah, I want to go see Wayne.
I'm jealous.
I think it was I Am Music, that's what it was called. Rihanna was there. Lil Wayne. Fucking T-Pain, I think, was there.
You've seen T-Pain?
Yeah, but it was in the arena. Like, we had, like, nosebleed seats. Like, that's why I was like, man, I don't fuck with concerts unless I can actually see them.
Yeah, and then, but that's a good one to go to. So that's one of your favorites?
No. I saw Nori there. Shout out to Nori. When Nori came out, I was like, damn, performed Nobody.
You mean nothing?
Nothing.
You gotta relax. Yeah. You know what's crazy is that the same day that we met EFN, we could have met Nori.
But, so you guys didn't meet him at the release, sneaker release?
No, because what ended up happening... Well, we got there. Honestly, we didn't... I wanted to go to that event because... shout out to Killa K. He's been on the show. Yeah, K Murda. He's been on the show episode 9. He was DJing there, and it was and I wanted to show it. Like, I wanted to pull up or whatever. And sure. I knew that it was a Drink Champs event. I didn't know that they were going to be there, though. Oh. So then by the time that we get there, it's just like... I'm realizing, like, these fools are gonna be there. And then I remember Kay was just like, yo, y'all just missed Nori.
Y'all just missed him?
He's like, he just left like 2 minutes ago.
Damn.
It like, relax. You know, it's like probably so more than 2 minutes.
EFN came after Noir?
No, EFN was there and he was just vibing. So I wanted to ask you, when you saw that EFN was on the show, like, what did you think?
No, I was just super fanned out. Cause I literally watched every episode of Drink Chats, like, since Fat Joe to, like, now.
Yeah.
And it's like, I was like, damn, it's incredible. Because, like, seeing him here in your house and shit, it was crazy.
Yeah, that's something that...
He's a real one for that.
Yeah. I just want to show mad love to the EFN. I just want to say thank you for coming. Not just because, like, you know, you're on a really big podcast and you really didn't have to come on the show. But honestly, just because, like, I learned so much from, like, having him on the show. Like, this man has been to to Vietnam. He has been to Haiti. He has been to Cuba. He has been to Peru in search of hip-hop. Like, a home in hip-hop. And it's just pretty dope because I got to see the documentary. Shout out to the documentary. It's ComingHomeDoc.com. I've seen already, I think, all of them. The only one that I think I'm missing is Haiti, and I think they have one in Colombia, and it's just mind-blowing to see, like, hip-hop in countries like Peru and Cuba and Vietnam. And Vietnam blew my mind because there was, like, graffiti artists, there were rappers, there were breakdancers, like...
That's wrong.
Yeah, and then today, it inspired me to ask my coworker, like, hey, so, like, because she's from France. So I'm like, so what type of music did you listen to growing up?
Oh, hip-hop is big in France.
Yeah, like, and then so she ends up telling me, she's like, oh, you know, we have, like, there's French rappers. Also, she's just like, back in the day, like, Dr. Dre was popular, and, like, Eminem, like, we hear that, and, like, all that stuff. So it was just pretty cool. But, yeah, so thank you to him. Also, thank you to all the guests that we've ever had on the show. Guys, this is episode 32. We got your boy C.A.B, not Cab. It's not Cab, you guys.
It's not Cab, but it could be Cab. I ain't tripping.
And C.A.B, for those that don't know, what is this?
It's my initials.
It's your initials. But we ain't gonna give your government name.
Yeah, no.
They might want to take that good credit, my boy. Oh, so I wanted to ask you, because you are a graduate. You graduated with your bachelor's, right?
I actually have my master's.
You have your master's. Yeah. My dog got his master's. You're like the first master, like, person with your master's that has been on the show. I gotta educate a motherfucker on the show. One time for education, guys. So what advice would you give to a college student?
Just don't let it pass you by the time. Make sure you use it productively. Because it's easy to get sidetracked and stuff. But don't get it twisted. You gotta have a good time. You gotta find that balance.
Yeah,
I would have never thought I was, like, gonna go crazy in college and stuff, but I'm gonna say it. We went a little hammer time. I mean, you guys met my friend, right, Kadeem?
Yeah, we did.
You met Kadeem?
Oh, no, I have met him. But I don't, but stories. I feel like I know him.
Yeah. No, but yeah, you just meet random people, but it's like you meet lifelong friends. So it's, I always just giving advice on my younger friends, like, if you're gonna go to college, like, try something else, like, go travel.
And what about somebody that's going for their master's?
Just focus, man. Buckle down. Don't, you know, you're paying for that, so don't waste your money.
And what is your master's in?
Accounting.
So y'all heard that. WTW don't just got artists. We don't just got artists. We don't just got a podcast. We don't just have, you know, this beautiful... girl, we also have an accountant. We have an audiovisual. Shout out to Hav. Honestly, I want to give a big ass shout out to Hav, because if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be going live. My life wouldn't be as easy as it is, because your girl does love to edit her own shows and her own episodes and the audio. But your boy Hav helped your girl out and is making it possible for us to be able to go live or to pre-record these episodes. What we're doing this week, guys, I'm pretty excited. We're dropping 2 podcasts in one day. So we're dropping...
They ain't 130 episodes.
I just wish this was the 33rd episode.
Dang. We can make it happen. We can make it happen, Carlos.
You said 32nd already.
Oh, yeah, times. We do. We have. You know what? It's okay.
Let's change it.
Hey, you know what? It's technically the 33rd. No, it's not. Is it? Well, kind of, because we've been doing more episodes. We've done one episode, but it's all good. what was it for? Okay, so we've been doing the live for a couple of episodes, so I'm really grateful. But what we're doing this time is we're doing two episodes in one day. So we're doing episode 32 and 33. I'm pretty excited because I already have the question of the week that I wanted to share with you guys. You're going to be watching episode 33 with the responses of what social media had to say. Basically, the question of the week comes from my insecure ladies and fellas that watch the show. You guys know that Dro, which is a character on the show, is married, right? And Molly, who is the main character of the show.
What show?
Insecure. Oh. Have you ever seen that show? It's
yeah,
on
I've
HBO.
Seen the first episode, yeah.
Bro, that show is awesome. Yeah, Issa Rae. She's bomb. I love her.
Yeah, I've seen the first season, but I just got HBO again back, so I'm gonna watch.
What did you think about the first season?
It's cool. It's like super personal. Like it's like super relatable. Everything.
Yeah, for sure. I love it because I feel like it's me.
Yeah. it's like conversations you would really have.
Yeah, it's the conversations that you would really have, and then like the awkwardness, and just like the whole thing, and then the storyline. The music is dope.
Oh yeah, yeah.
The music is dope as fuck. They actually like each episode they add new songs to their Spotify playlist. There's like a playlist on Spotify for the show. I learned a lot of new artists because of the show. Yeah, like I've heard about like 15 or nothing, 15,000, 1500 or nothing. I've heard of Rico Nasty, of a couple of other artists that are pretty dope. SZA was really popping like in the first season. So the character Molly, she's basically having a relationship with a married man that is in an open relationship. So for this week, my question of the week is, would you date somebody who is in an open relationship? So it's either yes or no. And then on episode 33, you guys will be able to see the responses. My response, because y'all know I like to keep it funky, will be at episode 33. So you guys need to make sure that you tune into that. Make sure that you guys vote. Share it if you want. Let the, like, you know, it's hashtag insecure question type of thing. I love that show, and I got a lot of great feedback talking about it on my Instagram. So it was pretty cool for me. Would you date someone in an open relationship? I have a couple fan questions, Carlos, because
sure.
Your fans got some questions. So,
shout out to the fans.
Shout out to the fans. Where would you say your rap styles come from?
I don't know, because, like, I'm not sure at all. But shout out to you, though, for that, that interview when you said I sound like, if I did sound like anybody, it would be Nas.
Oh yeah, you did watch that. Oh,
I took that like a super compliment.
Oh nice. It was hard for me to compare you to somebody.
Right.
It was super hard.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
Have said something of in between of a what have you have?
Where Kanye West and Mace meet.
Kanye West and Mace.
Well, that's my iPad, Jasmine. Shout out to Jasmine.
Shout out to Jasmine. Should we like answer, like have her log in?
I told her I was gonna have her
tune in on the show.
I told her I was gonna be on it today.
But yeah, it's super hard.
She's an avid listener.
She is. Oh, I love Jasmine. Yeah. Shout out to Jasmine. That's the homie right there. But it is hard to compare you to somebody. Another question that we have is, who are some of your favorite rappers?
You know, Kanye, Jay-Z, Mobb Deep, Fabulous.
Hey, Fab reminds me of you too. Well, you remind me of him, I guess.
Wale,
okay.
Yeah, Big Pun.
That's a good artist.
Yeah, those are all just influences. Make me want to start rap. J. Cole, big. J. Cole, Drake.
No. Ooh, speaking of Drake, Take Care or Nothing Was the Same?
I think Nothing Was the Same.
Yes! Did I tell you that you're my favorite little big brother? Oh, quickly, so shy.
But Take Care was fun. I remember Take Care because I was living here at the time. And,
Oh, you were living here. I remember that time because that time was
that a lot.
Some good car rides listening to that album. Which favorite song, which famous song did you wish that you wrote?
That's a great question. There's so many.
Shout out to the fan who asked it.
Who asked it?
Your fans, Carlos. It's anonymous.
What do they mean? So I know all four of them. No, there's so many. But yeah, Homecoming, Flashing Lights is definitely one of them. But so many. It's just so many. Wiz Khalifa. I love Wiz Khalifa too. Listen to him a lot.
He's the dang. I remember I used to have this one mixtape that someone made for me that was dope as fuck. That was Wiz, and it's like I think they even mixed it themselves and like put like certain things to like make it sound cooler. I love that album. I wish I could find it again. Wiz is a dope ass artist. It was funny that he was in the movie yesterday, and then what happens to him?
You didn't know he was gonna be in the movie?
Nah. I mean, I think I remember reading that there was gonna be people in it.
Cameos.
Yeah, like Jadakiss was in it. Khaled was in it. There's a couple of other people in it. Y'all gotta watch. You gotta watch it.
So, rest
yeah,
in peace, Q, for that. I think he's the one who made that.
Yeah, movie. He is the one, because like his name is on. Who is Q?
He's like the creator of World Star.
Oh, and he passed away.
Yeah, he passed away a long time ago.
Oh, dang. See, I didn't know that.
But that movie was like his baby, like he was like wanted to see it come into fruition, like a world star movie.
I think that's pretty cool because that inspires a lot of, because like at the end of the movie, something that they did say was just like shout out to all the hip-hop like dreamers or whatever. What would you say like hip-hop means to you?
It's just a getaway, you know?
It's just a getaway.
You do it every day. It's like a lifestyle.
Yeah.
But I don't know what it would mean to me, but...
What it would mean to you.
Like, it's not my everything.
It's not your everything.
But, you know, I love it. It's like, if it wasn't for music, like, I don't know what the fuck I would do with my time.
True. And so, I know that you have... two collab projects, because you have LA Vibe, which is on Apple, and then you have the one with Sosa, right?
Yeah.
The what is it? Cabana Classic.
Cabana Classics.
Okay, Cabana Classics, because you know, Cabana Classics. You guys, that's a really, I really like that project. It's a mixtape, right? Because I know you like mixtapes.
Yeah, we're gonna put it on Apple album, whatever it can be called, whatever. Just listen to it.
So are you planning on coming out with like a solo project?
For sure.
Do you have a time when you want to come out with it? Carlos, the fans want
to
know.
Yeah, they're waiting. Shout out to Chi-Chi. I talk to Chi-Chi all the time.
Oh, you do? Chi-Chi's one of the boys that we grew up with.
Yeah.
Neighborhood friend, yeah.
And he always tells me like, yo, when's the solo one dropping?
Nice.
He's always like bugging me about it, but you know, it takes a lot of time.
He's always loved you.
I'm like a perfectionist, like, which me and have had this conversation, like, just gotta put it out, just make it. It's not gonna be perfect, but I feel like if I don't like it, I don't want no one to hear it. I have to love it.
Yeah. You and Hav talk like every day, right? What would you say that relationship is like?
It's a brotherhood.
Aww.
For sure.
Does he get on your nerves sometimes? Because he gets on mine. No, I'm bugging. it's funny because he puts so much like heart into this.
Facts.
Like you can tell that with everything that he does. Like he does it with like wholeheartedly. Like he does it with like genuine intentions. And shout out to my little brother. I love him.
Shout out to him.
I love. He's just bomb. So we have this thing, you guys. It's called 21 Questions. Q50. So we basically have the 21 questions, and it's we did this with EFN. EFN 21 questions is basically, you know, like from the 50 Cent song, the I am. Mm-hmm. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and do it. These are 21 questions that have to do with hip hop, so don't worry. It's nothing crazy.
Yeah, you're like, a private person.
I know. Okay, so where was hip hop born?
New Jersey. 1992.
Yes. What song would you tell someone to listen to if they've never heard hip hop before?
Big Pun. I don't want to be a player no more.
That's a good one. Favorite hip hop movie?
Belly.
Ooh, that's my favorite. I love that movie. I love that movie. Favorite rapper turned actor?
DMX.
What came first, the DJ or the MC?
The DJ.
Favorite hip-hop/R&B song?
21 questions.
favorite hip-hop record label?
Rockefeller.
What's up? Rock Nation.
What was it? Put your diamonds in the sky.
Yeah, you guys heard that story?
Which one?
I don't know what he's talking about, but
which one?
The wedding where you got to grab the mic.
Oh, you told people to put their diamonds up at the wedding?
Yeah, I got a little lost in the music.
Bro, but if
we still, me and my friends still talk about that stuff because nobody put their diamonds up except me and the people I was with, but it was still like super funny.
It was still epic. I know I would have put my diamonds up for you.
That's right. I'm like, y'all whack.
But yeah, did you like grab the mic and do it?
Because the DJ was walking around with the mic, and I'm like, yo, let me see the mic real quick. Completely on 100, and I was just fucking so turned.
That, can you like please do that at my wedding? Like, I need someone. Well, they might have to put their dubs up instead of the rock. So favorite hip hop love song. It's different.
Hip hop love song. I would say.
Gold Digger by Kanye.
He said Gold Digger.
It's not a love song. There's not many love songs that I like.
So we skipping this?
I think we should skip it, but we should skip it.
All right. So, favorite region of the U.S. that had an impact in hip hop?
Bronx, New York.
Okay. Are you mad because I'm asking you 21 questions?
No.
first hip hop song you. The first song that you would play your kid.
Shook Ones.
Shook Ones. You're gonna play your kid that? I fuck with it. Did you ever want to break dance?
It's always cool. I'm not coordinated like that. I knew that at a young age.
So. Have you ever freestyled, like in a group?
Yeah, some drunk shit.
Was it good?
It's alright.
Tupac or Biggie?
Biggie.
Favorite hip hop movie soundtrack.
Hip hop movie soundtrack. I don't know, the Entourage movie had a good soundtrack.
One of my favorites is American Gangster.
American Gangster, too.
And then also the Black Panther one. Have you heard that one?
The Kendrick Lamar shit?
Bruh.
Yeah.
That shit's dope as fuck. I love that one. Hip-hop then or hip-hop now?
Hip-hop then, for sure.
Do you think that hip-hop is more about the art or popularity?
Now it's more about popularity. That's why.
Are you a fan of beef songs?
Yeah.
What's your favorite beef song? This is like another question.
Probably Jadakiss, Checkmate.
That's a good one. Does not writing your own songs make you less of a rapper?
Yeah, but does it make you less of an artist?
Okay, Carlos. I see that intellect. hip hop to me is blank. One word.
It's love.
Is what?
Love.
Aww.
It's vibes.
It's vibes. Okay, and last question. First hip-hop album you bought?
It was a Bad Boy one. Or it could be Nas-Stillmatic, too. I'm not sure which one was first.
Did you watch that 20-year Bad Boy movie?
Yeah.
That shit is dope.
Yeah, it was
Diddy's a boss. Yeah. Like, I love Diddy.
Yeah, Diddy's cool. I'm kind of low-key. His shit is so strong. His personality. Like, you have to get some money around him. There's no way not to.
That's what I like still. Like, it's funny because I tell Hav that I still want to work for Diddy. He's like, but you work for WT Dub. Like, and I'm like, bro, but is Diddy. Diddy calls me up and it's just like, yo, is Puff. And I'm gonna be like, but then I'm gonna be a sellout. And then I can't have the Ambition Hour podcast. So I don't know. Maybe not. Because he might try to like knock me. No, right? I don't know. I'm probably thinking about it too much. But because I think it's just something that I always wanted. And I always think about like when I'm going to meet him and like all that shit. Do you ever think that like that you're going to get to that level? That you're going to be like in the same room with like your favorite rappers?
I think so.
You think so? You see that future in this?
I see myself having a conversation with J. Cole all the time. Like running into him.
Mm-hmm. What would you tell him?
No, like, respect. Like, I saw your shit, like, coming up. Like, from Simba. From grown Simba.
Yeah.
To come up.
Yeah. That's cool. I met J. Cole and I met him drunk. It was a Memorial Day weekend and I got to meet him. And I kind of regret not having, maybe having met him at that time. I feel like I wish I would have met him now. Because I feel like it would have just been a different experience, like, yeah, to have met him. Have you ever met any celebrities?
A few right now that I can't really remember, but I met Tony Yayo. I met, one of my favorites.
So. Bro, he's awesome.
Yeah, but he was, like, on the move. I just dapped him up, and then it was a Knicks game. I saw him and just passed by. I was like, yo.
Charlie's so seductive and thing. Yeah,
but he was on the go. And I met Boss from J. Cole's.
Okay.
Dreamville. I met Lil Durk at the airport. And that's it, pretty much.
You went to Coachella with Hav, right?
Yeah.
How was that?
It was an experience, definitely.
You were there for 3 days, right?
Yeah, it was crazy.
You know what?
Huh?
You were going to say that you don't...
I don't regret going, but it was like too much for me. Like, one day, I needed a day to rest, but we went 3 days
straight. It was 3 days straight.
Yeah, all day in that fucking desert. It was crazy.
Quite an experience.
Yeah, it was raw. I don't regret it.
I'm upset you guys didn't see Beyonce.
True, we didn't see Beyonce. We were dead.
Who did you get to see there?
I saw Alina Baraz.
Love her, and I'm glad you said her name. Yo, right.
Her shit is dope.
Yeah.
That's the good thing about Coachella. You see, most of the artists are there. They're pretty underground. But you get to learn, hear their shit, get fans.
And I know in that same trip, you guys recorded Weekend in L.A.
Yeah, same trip, right after, yeah. Leaving Coachella, we drove to L.A., got to L.A., we went to the studio right there the same day.
And how was that? Like, because you guys were in the studio for how long, like, each day?
2 days straight, for like 4 hours.
Four hours.
Was it four or six? I don't remember how long we were there.
How many was it, Javier?
It was two sessions of like 4 to 6
like
hours.
Like mad hours?
Yeah.
Damn. And how did you feel?
No, we had fun. It was my boy, you know, just vibing. And we knew what we were going to do going in, so we knocked it out. And then the guy, the engineer, I don't really like recording with people I don't know in the room and shit. But the guy was super cool. Shout out to David. The engineer. His name is David Mason, right? Is it Mason?
I don't know if it's Mason, but yeah.
I know his name is Mason.
But I'll put his whole name out there.
Yeah, it's on his Instagram. I don't know. But yeah, super talented guy. Super wrong. He was giving us good feedback and he did a great job.
When it comes to, I guess, like hip-hop for you, do you just limit yourself to being a rapper, or would you like to like do other stuff like engineer or produce or make your own beats?
No, I low-key have a passion for engineering, for mixing and stuff. It's just I'm just getting into it now, just learning.
So you feel like that's gonna be do you feel like that's gonna help you a lot more, like you being able to do all of that stuff on your own?
Yeah, for sure. It has already, just because everything I've recorded, it's just me, myself.
which one of the songs that you record, it's, hold on, I got it on my Apple Music. I'm really bad with names of songs, by the way, Carlos, my people on the ambition now. It's Forever Fly. Right. That's a song that you dropped, right? Yeah. I like that song. Can we play? I'm gonna play a little bit of it. Do you get shy when you hear your music around people?
No.
No?
It's been happening the whole time I've been here.
That's so funny. I get hella shy when, like, I have the podcast playing around me. Yeah, I can't deal with it. I can't deal with it. But let's let it ride out a little bit. Turn it up.
Yeah. 30,000 feet up in the sky, never coming down, never. We forever fly, and I ain't gotta lie, who gon' tell me that I would never be right now, okay. Nigga wow, nigga wow, 30,000 feet up in the sky, never coming down, we forever fly, and I ain't gotta lie, who gon' tell me that I would never be right now. Through the sky, yeah, I know how I get down. I'm on a flight from Chicago, flying anywhere the sky go. I'm everywhere your mind go. Your best friend is a Tahoe. She a model, but in it for the love of Ray J. How long has she been gay? I'm looking to blow up like souffle. Take a closer look at me, baby. I am the right one. Voice of an icon. Just like a Nikon. You could learn something from me. Just turn me right on. Look. 30,000 feet up in the sky, we never coming down, we forever fly, and I ain't gotta lie, who gon' tell me that I would never be right now, nigga wow, nigga wow, look, 30,000 feet up in the sky, we never coming down, we forever fly, and I ain't gotta lie, who gon' tell me that I would never be right now, nigga wow, nigga wow, yeah, life in the fast lane, got them all asking how you live in the movie. Was never cast it, inglorious bastard, feeling like Brad Pitt, but with no Angelina. Okay, I hear you haters, bye bye, see you later. You subbing for the minors, I'm pitching in the majors. You still looking for parking, they valeting my latest. My California location in the valley, phone locating. 30,000 feet up in the sky, which means I'm fucking high. Seeing me from the ground on cloud nine, hearing me around is an honor from the God. Possession of my inside is keeping you alive. Look, 30,000 feet up in the sky, we never coming down, we forever fly, and I ain't gotta lie, who gon' tell me that I would never be right now, nigga wow, nigga wow.
Forever Fly by C.A.B, and I have C.A.B in the building. So tell me about that song, explain it to me.
It's just the beat, you know, and the beat, you hear the beat and then you just vibe to it, and then it all just comes to you. That's my process right there. It's just simple as that.
And Forever Fly, I feel like it fits you, because I feel like that's your mood a lot.
I have an aloof personality, I'm not gonna lie, but
an oh what?
An aloof.
Can you please tell me what that means?
Pull it up. pull up the dictionary. I can't really explain it, but it's like I feel like I
not friendly or forthcoming, cold and distant.
There we have it.
I'm really down to earth. It's just like,
I mean, it took us, I don't know how long. I had known him for like probably like I don't know, maybe like a couple of years, maybe like 2 or 3 years.
2 or 3 years?
We didn't start like talking for like until a while. Like,
no, because I didn't know you guys were so close.
Oh,
I'm like,
okay.
Oh, that's just Javier's big sister. Like,
yeah, no. And then, like, you realize, like, they're like, shit. Yeah, they're fucking close.
Yeah, like, when I go to Javier's house, like, I'm going to hang out with Javier and Claudia.
Bro, I remember there will be times that you introduced me as the infamous Claudia. Uh-huh. Can you tell, can you tell an infamous Claudia story or no?
Just super, super vibrant. Super vibrant personality. Always happy, always jolly. I don't know why. But yeah, it's never a dull moment.
Oh, man. Carlos has seen me at my worst. I'll never forget that time that we went to the beach that one time.
Yeah, it's a good time.
That was the really good time. That was a fun time.
What were you drinking that day?
We were drinking the samples from Wet Willie's. Remember, that was the day that I took.
Yeah.
Hey, if you ain't from Miami and you come to Wet Willie's and you come to Miami, we got a finesse for you.
Tell them the swindles on deck.
Tell them it's your first time.
The last time I went there was with, I think with Jasmine.
Are you still
my
you
girlfriend?
Pulled it.
Yeah.
Carlos, you guys heard it first. No, I'm joking.
But I was telling her the story. Like every time you come here, just. Do the same thing. Just
tell them it's your first time.
Try every drink.
All of them.
And then by the end there, you're already tipsy.
And then you get your drink, which is like, I don't know how much, and then you're good.
You got drunk off $9.
For real. I love having those type of memories with you. There was something that I know that you wanted to talk about. So we talked about Forever Fly, which is the song that you have on Apple. So shout out to that. That song is a song that is on Apple and it's under C.A.B, which is C.
Chinese Alphabet Boys. What is it?
That's who comes up if you search,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it is, unfortunately.
But
know
I think
who
if...
they are, but we're going to get them the fuck out of here.
You tell them,
words,
Carlos.
Words to Javier.
That is his... I love that about him because it's just like, to him, like nothing... is in our way.
Facts.
Like that's something. Oh, not a problem. He's like Shay Sharp. Yeah. Have you seen that meme? And he's like, not a problem. The one from
Shannon Sharp.
Yeah, the one with Kanye and Miles. What is it?
Yeah. Miles.
That's something that we've always done too. Is that like we watch sports like basketball or sometimes like my dad will have like barbecues and we would watch the games together. That would be cool, man. Growing up with you was cool. I'm very grateful to have had you in my life.
Same. Likewise. You guys, family. You become a family.
Yeah. But there was something. So we talked about Forever Fly that is on Apple. You can search for that on Apple. If you can't find it specifically on Apple, you can just always go to our website, you guys, which is wtwrecords.com. There, it's literally every single link to all of the music, all of the podcasts. If you are watching and you are new to the Ambition Hour podcast, I welcome you to join the family, the WTW fam, that is, by subscribing, leaving a review if you're listening to us on Apple or on SoundCloud. Shout out to SoundCloud, by the way. You guys, I did not know that the numbers were that much on SoundCloud. As much as they were, thank you for that. I really appreciate that. You guys know that any person that listens is... Even if it's just one person and sometimes that's me, I appreciate that. But apparently y'all fucking with the kids. So, you know, we gonna keep going. Episode 32. Okay. Back to that. It was the Eminem because Eminem came out with the project. I'm not an Eminem fan, but I do know what's going on. I knew he dropped a project and I know that he has a couple of disses on there. So I know that there's one with MGK. Can you enlighten me of this beat or of this diss?
I'm not sure what happened between them with Eminem and MGK, but they've been dissing each other for a while now. I'm not sure what the backstory is, but apparently he dissed them again on this Kamikaze album, and then MGK responded with like a super hard track.
And I know G-Eazy did too, right?
G-Eazy too, but MGK's was like surprisingly fire. Like I listened to MGK a little bit, like just that song that was on 2K though. What's it called? It was like Cleveland. Something about the land.
Yeah, the land, something
But it was on 2K, and then that was like my favorite song from him. But it was from playing 2K. But I didn't know he was like capable of.
Oh, like really?
Kinda. Really blacking out on a track like that. So, shout out to MGK. But it might be over for him. I'm gonna say
it. It might be over for who?
For MGK.
I think
if Eminem directs a whole track to him, I don't know.
It's not gonna go very well for a couple of people.
Yeah, but G-Eazy too. He responded with the track to MGK. So apparently, they're fighting over a girl or something like that.
Do you like
fight over girls?
No, because I know you don't. Do you think that's like something that is just becoming a trend now? Like you kind of start like a beef with somebody because. You know, kind of like for clout.
I mean, you gotta come up.
Oh shit, guys! This just in: Cabana Classics has over 1,500 plays. Is that on SoundCloud?
SoundCloud.
That's on SoundCloud. 1,500.
We gotta get it on Apple Music.
Carlos, that album that just dropped on Saturday. It's Tuesday.
Apparently, it's fine.
Bro, that. Did you say apparently it's fire? Bro, that is awesome. Congratulations. And shout out to Leiva Sosa too, who's also featured on the album. That's big. 15,000 plays. That means that a lot of people fuck with you. That's what's up. And you guys are gonna get on Apple, so that's gonna probably reflect there on too. But do you think that like this whole like, because I know like when Pusha came out with the album, he kinda like said some shit and then it kinda sparked the whole Drake, and then Drake comes out with an album and like, do you think that this is going to become, like, more and more of a trend when people are dropping albums?
If they need it, I mean, not to say that Pusha T needed to do that, but because they've been going back and forth for a while, so it's probably, like, really something he wanted to do. But I see people exploiting that shit, yeah, just to sell records. They've been doing it for a long time.
And I also noticed... I don't really like to talk about Nicki, but I thought that this was something that was kind of it's relevant enough to talk about because it's not too negative. But this whole thing that she has like with Tyga, that Tyga called in on Queen Radio. Did you hear about that or no?
No, I haven't heard about that.
Well, basically, like, cause Nicki Minaj has like her own thing, it's like Queen Radio or whatnot. Right, yeah. And she basically had like Tyga call in or whatnot. Tyga expresses that like Kylie Jenner basically like needed him to kind of get Kylie into the black culture because she needs the black culture to like succeed or some shit like that. So it was just like a whole bunch of drama.
He called in and said that?
He called in and said that.
To meet Nicki Minaj?
On Nicki Minaj's show. So, but Nicki also asked him like, do you think that you basically put like Kylie on? Type of thing, like Nicki asked him that, like, do you think that if you, like, but basically like if you and Kylie wouldn't have dated, do you think that she would have popped? I honestly think that she would because she's been on fucking TV since she was like 6-7 years old. So yes. If her sisters are popping, it really didn't take somebody that some people don't even really know about. You know what I mean? like don't flatter yourself, Tyga. But I just found it interesting, like, and then I feel like Nicki, instead of doing shit like that on her show, she should be doing more positive shit. Come on, we gotta be more positive out here. Y'all know that with the Ambition Hour podcast, it's all about positivity. There's no like fakeness, there's no gossiping. I only really bring artists that I genuinely like their music and listen to their music and can actually hold a conversation. I'm really happy because I got to have you on the show. I'm so happy. Do you want to go ahead and shout yourself out? Tell them your Instagram and where they can find your music.
Are we closing out right now?
We're closing out.
Oh yeah.
This ride's about to end.
We can keep going.
All right. It's only what, 9:34? Okay. So what else happened that was pretty important this weekend?
I'm not sure.
You went on the boat this weekend?
Right, I did go on a boat. Oh, you're talking about in my personal life.
Well, not in your personal life, but we can start there.
Yeah. I came with no real plans, but, like, I have so many different groups of friends that they're always, like, let's hang out. And then I finessed my way onto a boat. We went to the Keys.
Swindled his way in there.
You know, your boys for the free 99.
We also went to Foxhole and Purdy Lounge. Oh, yeah, that was pretty cool.
That night was fun.
I had so much fun that night. I love going out, like, and just dancing.
Yeah, I see that.
Because I didn't stop dancing. People who follow me, y'all saw.
Jennifer, yeah.
Yeah, and my story, I was like all over it. I was so excited to dance. It was cool because did you notice that in Foxhole they had like pictures of like artists that have passed away?
Oh, I didn't notice it was all artists that passed away.
Well, yeah, because they had like
I saw Leah, I saw Prodigy.
They had Amy Winehouse. They had Prodigy. They had Eazy-E. They had Biggie Pac, Bob Marley, Aaliyah, like you said. So it was just like, yeah, basically.
I didn't notice it was all, they've all passed, but yeah, it's dope.
Yeah, I thought that was pretty cool. I love that the hip-hop culture is, like, so around like that. Like, I love that shit. I love when I can go somewhere, and then it's just kind of like, I felt more like I was more welcome because of that. Because something did happen this past weekend. Is it okay if I talk about it? About the event on Saturday?
No, we don't.
Oh, okay. I guess we...
Scratch that.
But it's just like, I just like to know what the hip-hop culture, because a lot of the times what happens is that, you know, people put the hip-hop culture to the side because they think that, like, we're a whole bunch of gangbangers. It's just like, we just like to have fun.
Just like to party.
What albums that came out this summer are you fucking with?
Let me see. I got them on.
Pull out that Apple. The Apple. I really love that Everything Is Love a lot. The Teyana Taylor album was good too. Did you get a chance to listen to it?
Teyana Taylor, no.
No.
But I did like the Trippie Redd.
Trippie Redd. I think Spitz is like really like on that album, right? Like he likes it.
I got these boys on it.
I'm not gonna lie. I had no intention of listening to Trippie Redd.
No intention. I'm not no gonna intention. Lie. You know what's funny is that we were at Purdy and then like I think we ended up leaving. And you're like, what is it that he said?
I'm gonna say it.
We're gonna regret leaving this place. Yeah, and we ended up going back. Yeah. We ended up going back.
We left while it was like the most popular.
Something for people that come to Miami and kind of are not big fans of like Club Live or like any of those. We actually have some really cool like low key clubs. Like Purdy is one of them. Purdy stays open until like 5 a.m. Hello. Saturday they play like music, all types of different music, and then on Mondays I know they have reggae night. I love it there. I loved it. It was one of my. But okay, so what other projects is it that did you like the Drake album?
Yeah.
The Drake album was good.
Yeah, it's really good. I still listen to it.
You still listen to it?
I think the whole A-side was made after the whole Pusha T thing.
You think it was made after?
Yeah.
You think that he busted out that many songs after?
I think he had those
in the bag?
I think he did it.
You think he did it?
He added some, but...
Who, in your opinion, won?
I don't know who won, but...
In your eyes, Carlos.
Drake is up.
You know, he actually was the one who won because we did a poll of that when the whole beef was going on. Yeah, we definitely did a poll and Drake definitely won. Like, amongst my Instagram followers. Shout out to all my Instagram followers. Y'all are awesome. Thank you for always, like engaging in the polls that we do for the Ambition Hour podcast. Some of you guys even DM me. I appreciate that. Shout out to everybody who has subscribed. Like, I'm like, bro, like, just the fact that it's been more than 30 episodes, like, I am so grateful for that. Like, I just want to say, like, shout out to my mom, my dad, like, Hav, Spitz, Carlos, Layback, the whole WDub fam. Also, I want to give a big shout-out to DJ Anonymous, which is the person who I did the interview with.
Yeah, shout-out to him.
He was awesome. Were you surprised at some of the things that you heard in the interview?
Yeah, it was a lot of good questions and stuff that I feel like you answered really well. But it was really, really good questions that he asked you.
Yeah, it was funny because my dad, I was talking to him about something, and then he goes, oh, yeah, I liked what you said about Selena. And I'm like, what? What are you talking about? He's like, oh, in your interview. And I'm like, what? My aunt even watched that interview. Like, right. That was pretty crazy. I loved it. It was pretty, it's a pretty humbling experience because I'm always interviewing people.
Right, right.
So then, and I've always dreamed of, like, someone asking me questions. Mm-hmm. Could you tell, like, that I was just, like, I was ready.
Yeah, yeah.
I was just, like, I was so ready. It was funny, did you, because we shot it at a Starbucks.
Yeah.
So that was pretty cool. That I just want to point that out, that if you had gotten a chance to see that episode, well, it's the interview that I did with DJ Anonymous, he shot it at a Starbucks, like outside of a Starbucks. And as a podcaster myself, who is very comfortable, I have this space that I can do my podcast in. And sometimes I would feel ashamed when I would have a special guest come on the show and it's just like in my living room or whatnot. This man literally has and does his podcast at a Starbucks. So I just want to commend him for that. Shout out to DJ Anonymous. Definitely was not against doing an interview there. I kind of was just trying to picture it. But I believe in anybody's vision. So shout out to Sports Biz Music for that. Also wanted to give a big shout out to Mileto Beats, who was also in the building for episode, like he wasn't here for episode 31 with Treece. Shout out to Treece and DJ for being here for episode 31. Y'all know I love me some Treece and that voice of his, so I had to bring him back on the show. He's the first guest that we have on the Ambition Hour podcast that has come 2 times. That's how many episodes we've had that we get a chance to have somebody on for a second time, like twice. That's awesome. And so, okay, so episode 31. but yeah, so I'm just very grateful because, like I said, like I'm very comfortable with, you know, and I know how hard it is to do a podcast and all this stuff. And he was just doing it by any means necessary and basically working with what it is that he has. And that's something that I like to also preach on the show, that you don't have to have anything special. You just have to have the desire to want to do what it is that you want to do and chase your goals and chase your dreams, because no one can take that away from you at the end of the day, because you only have one life to live. So I have this thing that we do, which is called Thank God I'm Ambitious. I just want you to go ahead and say thank God. It's Thank God I'm Ambitious, and then you just say why you thank God that you're ambitious. Bam. 3, 2, 1.
Thank God I'm ambitious because?
Yeah, and then you go ahead and fill the blank.
Because 2 years ago, I didn't know what the hell I was going to do with my life, even after college. But I flipped it, and I'm living pretty good right now. I'm in a good place. So I'm just grateful for that.
Aw, I'm grateful for that too. Shout out to God for keeping all of us ambitious here on the WTW fam. I like your wallet, by the way. You shining. You flossing for them on the Ambition Hour podcast?
I don't know if they can see it.
No, it's cool. They probably couldn't see it. Okay, so I am going to wrap up this time. Is that okay with you, Carlos?
Yeah, sure.
I think it's about that time, Carlos. We don't really have that many guests. I'm here for more than an hour. But you know, you're my other little big brother, so we made the exception. They can follow you on DonCab3.
DonCab3 is my Instagram, yes.
Okay, and then do you use any other social media that they can hit you up on?
I have a Twitter, Carlito's Way, but...
Instagram's where it's at.
Instagram's where it's at, and YouTube is going to get started soon. As soon as I go to Best Buy and get a fucking camera.
And the what?
On WTW.
And then on WTW TV.
On WTW TV.
Oh, because you're going to be posting content on WTW TV, right?
Yeah, that's the plan.
Yeah. I mean, we are, bro, you guys think that we drop too much shit? Wait until we get like a little, like, just like give us more time and then just watch how much content like is going to be popping, because we just all have so many different ideas that are just going to pop off. So make sure that you go to the website wtwrecords.com, go to the Instagram, we have Worth the Wait Records, that's Instagram, the Ambition Hour podcast on Instagram as well. You can follow me, I'm AuDii Ambition. If you're listening to us on SoundCloud and Apple, thank you very much. That is WTW TV for YouTube, and then WTW Radio for SoundCloud and Apple. So thank you for tuning into that. We're gonna be you want him to pick a song? So pick a song from Cabana Classic. Cause we gonna play that bit. What we closing out the show with, Carlos?
What type of vibe are we in, guys?
It's been chill today. It hasn't been raining, so I'm kind of like, which one, Javier? The crowd wants to know. We want to know which one.
Man, we gonna end this thing right now with the vibrations.
Vibrations.
This is Layback Salsa, C.A.B. Records. Me and this bitch.
Yes, and so for episode 32. It's your girl, AuDii 3000, the Ambition Hour podcast, and we out. Guest out, bingo. No, it's all good, but we good. Bye. Thank you, Carlos.
Come and catch it. Come and catch it. Come and catch.
I just wanna catch a vibe. I just wanna smoke and ride. Puff it past a little time. Won't you catch a vibe with me?
Come and catch it.
Come and catch a vibe with me.
Come and catch it.
Come and catch a vibe. I just wanna catch a vibe. I just wanna smoke and ride. Puff and pass a little time. Won't you catch a vibe with me?
Catch a vibe. Catch a vibe.
Vibe with me.
Catch a vibe. Catch a vibe.
It could all be so elusive, running with me so exclusive. If your energy's too intrusive, then trust me, you'll be excluded. Let's roll up and watch a movie, in a blunt, in a doobie. As long as you're right next to me, everything is going smoothly. Keep that fuck shit from around me, that dark shit from around me. All good vibes around me, I keep my rhymes around me. My blessings, they surround me, I give my G's like a pound of peace. Trust me, we might blow that in a day, no place. Said I'm floating at the moment, it's pretty women in potent potion, pouring perfect portions for the low end. Right now it's no worry, just some floating, please just don't interrupt that shit. If it ain't positive to the kid, right now. Fuck that shit. Oh baby, won't you come and take a ride with me? Oh baby, won't you come and take a ride with me? I can show you all the finer things. Time is of the essence, don't you miss this blessings. They know what I'm reppin', I get to the money. Ain't no other question, I ain't standing trial. I don't have to speak too much, shout it, love the style. Roll up, hold up, yig it when I show up, hold up. Like my Henny with no soda, rolling paper, smoking Yoda. Another week, another stay, money coming, never slower. Bitch, I get it when it's due, counting till my fingers blue. Don't you wanna make a move? I've been on my P's and Q's. Don't you ever get confused, dubs up, never lose. Like my women, like my shoes, yeah, that's by the two. Nigga, you just press and snooze, we up early on the grind. Sun shines after I do. And baby, I just stunt when they try to. Claiming that they fly when I been flew. See, they love the fake, I remain true. Let me vibe with you. I just wanna catch a vibe, I just wanna smoke and ride. Puff and pass a little time, won't you catch a vibe with me?
Come and catch a vibe with me.
Come and catch a vibe. I just wanna catch a vibe, I just wanna smoke and ride. Puff and pass a little time, won't you catch a vibe with me?
Catch a vibe, catch a vibe.
Vibe with me.
Catch a vibe, catch a vibe.